Today, we're taking a look at SketchUp's newest plugin, Diffusion. Diffusion is an AI rendering software that is directly part of the SketchUp interface and works like any other prompt style render, like Midjourney, DALL-E, or Stable Diffusion. But the major difference between this and the others is that it's directly interfaced within SketchUp, so we can use it in a ton of different ways than we could use it with the other programs. So make sure you stick around to the end to see this program to its full extent. Now, the plugin is really easy to set up. All you need to do is head on over to SketchUp's extension warehouse. You can find it within the extension tab. Search for Diffusion and then install it to SketchUp. Now, I should mention right now that this plugin is only available for the pro users and it's also available on the iPad. However, if you do have it, it's really great because it is available on all your platforms. It's available on Mac, PC, and the iPad. Now, once it's installed, you can either find it through the extensions tab or you should have a little icon that shows up like the rest of your tool set that will show Diffusion. And if you're on the iPad, within the settings tab, there is a little icon for Diffusion down at the bottom of the menu interface. But now that you have it set up, let's take a look at how you can start to use this program. Now, if you haven't opened up before, the first time you open it up, it will have a few dialog boxes that will run through the different options, but let's talk about them quickly. At the very top, we have our dialog box for a prompt. This is where we would write out our narrative with a bunch of different keywords to hopefully help describe and tell SketchUp what we want the output to be. Then below that, you have your styles preset options. Now, it's important to know you don't have to choose a style at all when you're doing your image creations, but you might find that it's helpful to play around with the different styles in order to find what works best for what you're looking for. And then below that, you have your settings tab. This is where you can change how much the prompt influences the output or how much of the geometry that you have in the model it needs to respect when it creates an output. We'll talk more about the best settings for this in a minute, but let's finish off by talking about the last tab, the scenes. Now, this is where SketchUp becomes so much different from all of the image generating styles out there like Midjourney and the others, because it's going to take your SketchUp model directly as the base for what it needs to make the render off of. So what this means is you'll have the opportunity to create a series of renders from a bunch of different views in your model without having to go through a bunch of hoops and ladders on trying to figure out how to create that image, that thing you're looking for down the road through different prompting and other engineering ideas that you would need to know in Midjourney. And that's again because SketchUp uses your model as the base ground for what it's going to output, and it preserves so much of that model that it still very much looks like the kind of outlines of what you drew or created in the model, rather than trying to use something else and it looks close but not what you want to have the output be. So with that said, let me walk you through my process and how I use it and how I think it stacks up to the other AI generators out there right now. Now, before we just jump in and start creating it, I like to do 2 to 3 things just to set up the document so that it can be the easiest to start creating and it looks the way you want it before you actually start going and making those generations. And to do that, the first thing I'll do is I'll kind of look around my model and see which scenes or views that I want to have the input be and start to add a scene or two within SketchUp on those outputs. So here's a couple scenes that I've set up through the 3D warehouse for a mixed use apartment. And I'm going with the basic composition, rule of thirds composition, that has the focal point as that apartment. Then the only thing I like to do after that is if you have a lower kind of viewport, you wanna make sure that you're setting the model to a 2-point perspective so that way the vertical lines are actually vertical and it starts to look a lot more realistic to the eye than if you were still in perspective mode on SketchUp. But then let's head back on over to the Diffusion tab and import our first view to start rendering off of. To do this within the scene window, all you need to do is hit refresh input and it's going to put in whatever you're currently looking at on the screen in SketchUp into that little dialog box for you. Now, I like to move from top to bottom through the settings, the first being the prompt. Now, depending on where you are in your kind of process, you might want to keep the prompt as simple as possible just to give you a maximum range of options, or you might want to do the opposite and get very specific if you have something in mind that you know you want the output to be. Now, I will say the more detailed the model is, the better your results will be right now with Diffusion, but it still works pretty good with very loose blockings and massings of things that you're working on. But from here, if you have a prompt you like, you can just hit generate and it's gonna produce three images down below for you to look at. Now from here, there's a variety of things you could do. You could either save it, or you could import that view into the render and then redo it, or you could just keep your original view, tweak settings and re-render it. So let's say you didn't get something you like. The first place I would go back to is your prompt and start to create a little bit more of a narrative for that prompt so that it starts to put out better output for you. A good tip and tool that is really great for this is to actually head on over to ChatGPT and type in a narrative and have it describe it to you in a Midjourney format or a DALL-E prompt. That way it'll really help you kind of put in a good prompt for Diffusion, so it hopefully gets you closer to that result you're looking for. Then you could regenerate this, and if you're still not closer to what you're looking for in terms of the quality, maybe you want to start to play with the styles. Now, personally, I think the two best styles are the interior or exterior photorealisms. I think they are the most realistic right now, and the others are kind of cool, but still kind of a work in progress, in my opinion. And then if that still doesn't work, the last resort is to start playing around with the settings. And what I found for the settings is very much dependent on where your model is. If your model is very developed and at the point where you would bring it over to Lumen or Enscape, you might want to turn the respect geometry down a little bit and the prompt influence up, so that way it starts to kind of put a higher load of render on that final product. Whereas if you have something as simple as very rudimentary massing blocks, I find that turning the respect geometry up and the prompt influence down helps create a more realistic looking result. But again, my piece of advice is to treat this as any other iterative process that you would go through in design. You need to tweak settings, play with different words, see how different things react to what you're doing, and remember that information and start to apply it to anything else you're working on. But let's say you finally found a good image out of the three it generated. You could either save it from here, add it to your scene where it would then add into SketchUp, and then you could add it into your views if you're doing a slideshow or something like that. Or you can then try to render even further on top of that base image. This is because SketchUp only does a render for what is imported into that viewport. So let's say you wanted to go back to your original image, you'd have to refresh the input view and it would go back to your base model view that you could then render on top of. But if you find something in your direction, you want to keep going further in that direction, make sure you put that render into your input view and then re-render on top of that, and it will start to kind of build upon that model. And that's how kind of the building process would work to get a better result in SketchUp. And then aside from that, the last feature that you can do, which is kind of a little bit of a hack, is you can import a photo into your model and then do a top-down view, have the scene be the extents of that photo, and then you can go through the normal rendering process and it will take that image as if it was a model, so you'll be able to preserve those edges, those boundaries, and be able to create some sort of result that is AI rendered from that. But with that said, here are some of my favorite results I've had using Diffusion so far. So overall, I would say my review right now is that it's okay. I think it's a really interesting tool and it will become very prevalent, I believe, in the SketchUp world and people who kind of use this tool in their normal workflow. I think it's really important that right now we learn these programs, because in a year or two, this is probably going to be developed to a point of Midjourney and even further, where being able to preserve that model and then have beautiful outputs like a Midjourney or a DALL-E within this one app. But with that said, I think the best results right now are either with something that's very building or interior heavy. I know the interior ones work very well for architects, and I think exteriors that have a lot of buildings tend to work a lot better because it's just hard lines, whereas it struggles a lot more with biomorphic, you know, landscapes. Which is a bit disappointing, as this is a landscape architecture and urban design channel, but That said, if you do have a very detailed landscape model, it will work much better than if you just had something that's very loose. Anyways, let me know what you think of this program in the comments below, if you think you'll be using it or not, and where you think this will go in terms of the endless tools that seem to come out about AI. And also, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give this a like. I really appreciate that. And be sure to check out my channel for tons of other content on design, architecture, and landscape architecture. Anyways, thanks for watching, and here are a couple videos I think you'll find helpful next. Peace.